I have a maths puzzle I would like to share with you. It's one I very much enjoyed working on, even though I haven't had a chance to finish it. And that's because I spent the last 3 weeks at the Edinburgh Festival Fringe, the biggest arts festival in the world. There are over 4,000 shows, including some rather quite nerdy ones. And because there are lots of other nerdy performers around, we've been trading interesting bits of maths. And a friend of mine, Timandra Harkness, has been doing a show all about risk. She looks at the statistics and human approach to risk. And after one performance, someone came up to her and gave her a maths puzzle.
Okay, Timandra, what is the puzzle?
The puzzle is, suppose you have a frog.
Which you have made.
Which I've made out of pipe cleaner.
So good.
It's been a long fringe.
It really has.
The frog's on one bank of the river.
Yep.
And it wants to get to the other bank of the river.
Now, oh yeah, over there.
Yep. This is a pretty athletic frog.
So it is capable of leaping the whole lot, going straight to the far bank.
And I guess 1 times in 10 it will do that.
Yes, exactly, because it's equally likely to pick any of the intermediate points or the bank. Well, this is the question. All right, so it's never going backwards.
Right.
It's a frog with a one-track mind. I don't know what's on this bank that it wants, but it's only going one direction. But once it's gone to here, it's equally likely to pick any of the remaining pads or the bank.
Yep.
Once it's gone to here, it's equally likely to pick any of the remaining three or the bank.
Yep.
So at any point, it's equally likely to choose any of the options left to it. So then the question is, at the start, what is the expected number of jumps that it will take?
Right. So what's the kind of the average number of jumps required?
Exactly. If it crossed this river many, many times, what's the average number of jumps that you'd expect it to take?
And is it just for, or like, obviously there's like a value, there's some number for 10.
The problem was set to me by Ben Gillott, and he said it's actually a question in two parts. The first one is, if you've got a frog with a maximum of 10 jumps and a minimum of 1 jump to cross the river, what is the expected number of jumps? So the expected number for 10. But can I also get an explicit formula that would tell me for any number of jumps, for any width of river, basically, for any width of river with any number of possible jumps, what is the formula, not a recurrence relation, he was really clear about this, the formula that will tell me how many jumps you'd expect him to take.
I'm actually staying in the same flat with Timandra and a few other nerdy performers, and that night when we were out for a drink with a few maths friends who were visiting, Timandra gave us the puzzle she had received after her show that day, and we got to work pretty quickly. I actually went for a simulation technique as opposed to everyone else because they're working it out in theory, so I thought, you know what, I'll write some Python code. I will send millions, maybe billions of frogs across the 10 possible jumps and then get an average. And then I tried to generalize that a bit. So if there were N possible landing places, what was the average number of jumps? And then I plotted those results to see what it would look like. And I realized pretty quickly I was just kind of reading tea leaves at that point. So I'll put a link to my code in the description. It's not great. I wrote it very fast in a bar at the end of a long day. So there's probably mistakes. If you can fix them or you want to alter the code, please do see if you can get an estimate or a pretty good average, I reckon, for 10. I then did try and do it in general as well, and I have to admit I went for a recursive relationship. I tried to work out if there were N possible landing places to start with, how could you take all the previous results to get the next one up. And slight spoiler, this is the equation I came up with. I think it works, it matches the results I was getting from the simulation, so it seems possible, but I'm still a long way from getting a explicit formula just taking the N possible landing places. So do have a go at it. We had a great time in the bar. We were all doing it on the back of the flyers for Timandra's show. And then when we finally gave up on doing some maths, we turned all our working out into a dodecahedron. But then the following night, after I finished my performance, a friend of mine who's also doing a show in the same venue here at the Pleasance Dome, actual dome up there, I shared the problem with her, and even though she is not a math person, she also got a bit obsessed, and she's backstage here at the moment. And here she is, it's comedian Beck Hill, who's been doing a show as well called I'll Be Beck,
yeah.
Which you're never doing again.
Never doing it again.
No, you are. You've had your last show and you're done.
That's it.
So I gave you this puzzle.
Yes.
In the venue bar.
Yes.
And you got a little obsessed because I woke up the next morning to say, what's that message? Can we see
in
this?
In my defense, I was hungover.
Yep.
And it was the first thing I thought of when I woke up.
That's so good. Okay, right, let's see it.
So this was my attempt at trying to count out all the different ways that the frog could
this
jump.
This is so good.
I ran out of space. I had to go that way as well. So I just started to realize that obviously the patterns start to mirror each other. So like you've got the jumps start to go down on a diagonal and then they go back down again. And then
and
I realized like,
I'm
a very visual person. And so for me to understand a problem, I have to get the full visual of it. I can't just like do it all in here. And so doing that, I was like, oh, I see. So if it does that and then it does that, diagonally with the jumps, then it's going to mirror each other, so we're going to get like a vague similar thing once you hit an apex, then go back down, and I guess if you were to graph it, it'd look like a bell curve.
Yeah.
But
and then you've got some extra numbers that you've put at the top here.
Yeah, although some of my numbers are very much not.
Well, what I love is, I saw this when you sent me in the WhatsApp messages, and I saw this and went, oh, it's Pascal's triangle. And then I noticed...
But then, yeah.
Well, you got up, like, here you're like, oh, it's not symmetric anymore, and over here it's slightly off.
And then six was like, what?
Yep, but...
I've got 169, 2615. Yeah, I don't think that's right.
Well, what's interesting from a maths point of view is mathematicians wouldn't be at all surprised to get slightly wrong numbers, but then because they've done so many maths puzzles before, they just go, oh, that's Pascal's triangle, and they'd recognise the pattern, and that's, ah. Oh, I think you've done an amazing job.
Thanks.
Also staying in our flat were Morgan and West. They're magicians, but they were doing a kids' science show this year. And Rob of Mr. West fame came up with a very interesting way to simulate what the frog is doing.
So what did you do, Rob?
So I made a game?
Game for a very, very...
Simulation. I mean,
simulation. It's a very generous definition of a game.
It's my frog simulator, jumping frog simulator.
And this is it.
This is it on game. There's some real ugly code in here. I'm sure people can be cross. This is it.
I see it.
So it should run.
Oh, and there it is.
So obviously you can just...
Oh, it's you hit space.
You hit space and the frog will randomly jump to one of the spaces in front of it.
And it gets a little hat at the end. Oh, can I play? If I just hit...
Yeah.
Oh, that's great.
And it's randomly choosing from the jumps ahead of it. So each time the possible things before it decreases and it randomly puts one of them.
Great, and it keeps track of it on the side over here. So at the end you can see what the average is. Well, have you programmed in like the parabolic... arc for each one?
Only very crudely. I give it an upwards movement based on the distance it's jumping, and then it will jump up and then drop down that distance.
That's great. You want accurate physics in your math simulation.
Yeah, you need accurate physics in your frog simulation. And then obviously that'll take a while pressing the space, so I also added auto frog.
Oh, which, that's great. So there you are, no one was able to solve the frog problem, and it's now the absolute last day of the Edinburgh Fringe. Final shows are happening, everyone's packing down. My last show is at 8:20 tonight. And so yeah, it's up to all of you to solve the problem. You've got two options. You can either try to work it out properly, and feel free to discuss that in the comments below, or have a guess. So your first instinct, maybe have a very quick think about where the frog would land on average. I mean, I don't even know if this is a good idea. Just see what your intuition says and put my guess is, and then put the number in the comments for 10 possible landing places. And use the word guess in case anyone wants to work out the average of all of the guesses, as I have no doubt someone will. And if you want to try more problems like the frog problem, this video as well as my channel is supported by the fine people at Jane Street. They like solving complicated mathematics problems from the financial world, but they also enjoy all sorts of problems. If you want some other similar puzzles and math things to work out, check out their real number series. It's particularly good for teachers, but anyone can have a go. I will link to that in the description. And everyone else you've seen in this video, they're all good friends of mine, as well as being fantastic performers, and they're either on tour or doing more shows. I'll link to them below, as am I. I mean, I'm taking Humble Pie on tour in October and November around the UK. Links below, but I will leave you now with a final burst of Frog Simulator.